Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see the MIUI CAF ROM 7.1.2, which is based on Android version 9.0 Pi. it is based on Android version 9.0 Pi. So let's begin. As you guys know that the ROM is not Android 9.0 Pi, but as you can see here, it is showing no GUT. So I just want to confirm that it is on Android 9.0 Pi. I downloaded the CPU-Z. As you can see here, it is showing Android version 9.0 Pi. So yeah, it is confirmed that it is the Android 9.0 Pi, but here it is showing no GUT. I don't know why. And here, as you can see, model number, it is showing a Redmi Note 7. I assume that it is the ported ROM from Redmi Note 7, and yeah, that is it. So guys, this is it. And the kernel here, I don't know what kernel here it is. It is just showing the kernel version here is just not available, so we just don't know what kernel here it is. So guys, then moving forward to the settings here, these are the settings, just the same settings, so I'll just not show it everything. You get to see the wallpaper, display, themes, sounds and vibration, lock screen and password. Everything here is just the same. Now talking about the lock screen and password here, the fingerprint here is just not working, so you just have to take a note of that. So fingerprint here is just not working. And the home screen and recents, you get to see the system launcher available here and everything. So yeah, this is it. Then I'll just show you the additional settings. These are the additional settings. You get to see the ad block here. I don't know if it is working or not, but you get to see the ad block here and the location and everything. You get to see the enterprise mode, authorization and all the sorts of customizations. As you, this is like the stock MIUI ROM here, so you know there are no external customizations or anything available here. This was it. This is the settings app, and this is the home screen. As you know, the MIUI home screen, just the system launcher here is available. This is the control center available here, as you can see here. As you saw that lag here, so yeah, this is a problem. Then talking about the quick settings here, as you can see here, the mobile data here is just working absolutely fine. 4G VoLTE here is just working. I have the VI SIM card, and the Wi-Fi here is also working absolutely fine. So yeah, that is great. And this is the, you know, recent apps panel here. As you know, the MIUI 10 one, this is ROM is based on MIUI 10. So yeah, and the Wi-Fi here is also working absolutely fine. Flashlight, everything here is just working. So yeah, that is great. And you get to see the screen recorder option available here, and the call recorder option here is also available here. So yeah, this is the home screen. And now let's just talk about the camera here. This is the camera, but it is of as soon as you capture a photo here, the phone just gets hanged. As you saw, the phone just got hanged. So this is a bug present here. I'll just meet you after the reboot. So as you guys can see here, this is the boot animation, and it's something new. Yeah, as you saw, it is something unique, boot animation, the whole video is just playing. So guys, if you still haven't subscribed to the channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel, and that will be the name of the Telegram group here. You can join the Telegram group, and the link will be in the description below. So join the Telegram group if you still haven't joined it. So guys, the phone has booted, and let's just move to the camera here. As you saw that the camera was just not working. As soon as you click a photo, the phone just got hanged, but the video here is just working absolutely fine here, and in the HDR video are just superb. I will just leave the card of the Poco X2 video I have just shot previously. You can just watch that video. I shot it on Redmi Note 3 on this camera, on this ROM, and using the HDR. So you can watch that video if you want to see the camera video quality of this ROM here. It was shot on 1080p 30fps. So you can just see that video. The quality here is just amazing. So yeah, this is it. And in the quick settings here, as you can see, it just shows the free RAM, the battery temperature and everything, CPU and the CPU temperature and everything. So it just shows up here. Otherwise, then talking about the safety net here, safety net status has just not passed. I just show it to you. The safety net status has not passed, and here also it is showing the device, your Redmi Note 7. And the Play Store here has also not certified. I'll just show it to you and the settings. And as you can see here, device is not certified. So this is a bit problem here for the Play Store and other stuff. The safety net and the banking apps here will not run, even though I have rooted the phone, and the magic here is just working. So yeah, this is a bit problem here. Then talking about the Geekbench scores here, the performance here, I must say the performance here is just not that great. The Geekbench score, I was just not able to run. I was able to run, but after around 70%, the phone just got crashed. Like, the application just got crashed after 70%. I don't know why. So here, as you can see, it is showing model number Redmi Note 7. The Android version is showing 9.05. And these, as you can see here, the CPU is showing the Qualcomm Snapdragon 660. So yeah, this is the score. This is what it is showing. This is a ported ROM from Redmi Note 7. Then talking about the Wi-Fi speed test and the internet speed test, everything here is just working. I'll just show it to you, the internet speed test here. So as you can see, here are the results. The download is 47.4 Mbps and the upload here is 29.9 Mbps. Now I'll just show you the speed test on the mobile data. So this is what the speed it is getting, 9 Mbps on the 4G. So I'll just skip it to the results now. So download speed, as you can see, it got 21 Mbps, and upload, let's see to it. So as you can see here, the upload speed we got here is the 15.7 Mbps, so that's impressive. So yeah, this is what the speed we got in the 4G VoLTE Vi SIM. And I don't know for the Airtel SIM, most probably it is not working. Airtel SIM here is just not working, most probably, I just assume it. So yeah, Airtel SIM here is just not working. And this is the app vault you get. So guys, then talking about the security app, this is the security app you get. It is not the fully updated one, as you can see in the battery usage stats and everything. So yeah, this is not the fully upgraded one. And talking about the battery life here, the battery life here is also just not that great on this ROM. So yeah, battery life here is also a bit problem here. Otherwise, as you can see, this is the security app, and there is a bug in the gallery here. I'll just show it to you. As soon as you try to run a video here, I'll just show it to you. As you can see, this is a video from the PPOS, the screen recording, and as soon as I try to run it, it just shows me where to copy the file. So as you can see, where it just directly shows me to paste the file, the video will just not run. So yeah, this is a bug present here. As you can see, I'll just show it to you again. As soon as I try to run the video, it just shows me to paste it. So yes, this is a problem, and that is it. Now let's just talk about the bugs here. You know, there are bugs. The phone just gets hanged a lot. You know, the performance here is just not stable. When you open more than two apps in the background, the phone just gets hanged, and the multitasking here is just not possible on this ROM. So this is the problem with it. The performance here is just not that great. The phone just hangs a lot, and the safety net status here is not passed. And the fingerprint sensor here is just not working. So this is also a problem. And there is a random reboot bug here. I have faced a random reboot problem. So overall, I must say this ROM is just not stable here. Though the VoLTE and everything here is working, but the ROM is not stable. Fingerprint sensor here is also not working, and the camera here is also not working. There is no Gcam available on the Play Store, or you will not be able to install. The phone just gets hanged. And so these are some problems available here. That was it, and I will just not recommend you to use this ROM because it is very buggy ROM. So this is not something for a daily driver. If you want to just try it out, the Android 9 Pie on this MIUI 10, so you can just try it out for fun, but it is not for daily driver ROM. So guys, that's it for now. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, then you can ask me in the comment section below or in the Telegram group. I'll meet you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, have fun, and goodbye.